ויר יוסף כי יושיס אוביב, יד ימינוי על ראש אפרים ויירו בעינוב, ויסמוך יד אוביב להוסיר אויסו מעל ראש אפרים, על ראש מנשה. The Torah makes a big asik with the hands of Ephraim and Menashe and Yosef and Yankev. What is all this about? Believe it or not, many halachos of Hilchos Tefillin are learned from this parasha, from this psukim between Yaakov and Yosef. Why the Torah says over here, Yad Yeminoi and Yad Stam? The Gemara says in Menachos, Daflam Zayin Medalev, Ukshatim Lo Sal Yodecho, what means Yodecho, Zoi Smol, left hand. Tefillin you put on the left hand. Ato Oimer Smol, Oy Eno Elo Yemin, maybe means the right hand. Tamut Loimer says in Yishayo, Yodi Yosdo Oretz, Vimini Tipecho Shomayim, my hand created the earth, and my right hand created Shomayim. Stam Yad means small. Standard hand means the left hand. We find Yod, which means standard hand, and it also means the right hand. Where? By Yosef. Yosef grabbed the hand of his father, which was on the head of Ephraim. Which hand was that? The right hand. So when we say the word Yod, it also means the right hand. So how do you know that when the Torah says Ukshartem lo'ois al yodecho, it means the left hand? The Gemara answers, Yad yemino ikri yad, stamo lo ikri. You don't find the word Yad to mean the right hand unless it says Yad yeminoi. Tosis as a kashe. In Posik says Yad yeminoi and says also Stam Yad uviv. So you see that the Posik calls Stam Yad even though it's a right hand. What is Pshat in Rabbi Yosei Achoyrim? So Tosis says, Adrabo, since the Torah had to write over here Yad Yeminoi, and in the same post it says Yad Oviv, is to tell you that unless it says Yeminoi, it means Yad Small. And from here, actually, Tosis says, is that we learned Aloho that standard Yad means Yad Small. Unless the Torah says Meferesh, Yeminoi or Yad Yeminoi. And from this post we learned the Hilchos Tefillin. Yankev Avinu Pus, his left hand on the head of Menashe. And he tells them, Menashe, we're going to learn now Hilchos Tefillin. Tone de Bei Menashe, al yotcho zoiki boires. When the Torah says you put on tefillin on the hand, doesn't mean any place in the hand. It means on the kiboires. How do you know that? There's three way machloikis. Tanekamo, Rabbi Eliezer ben Hurkunus, and Rabbi Yitzchok. The Tanekamo is going to learn from a hekesh of tefillin shel yad to tefillin shel roish. When the Torah says Bein Einecho, does not mean between your eyes, but means begoiva sheberoish, all the way on top. So make a hekesh of tefillin shel roish to tefillin shel yad. When the Torah tells you al yotcho, it doesn't mean on your hand and your wrist. It means begoiva sheberoish, in the high part of your arm. And the hekesh is merumos sikeles yodov. The left hand is resting on the right hand, and the right hand is on top of the head of Ephraim, al roish Ephraim. We have a hekesh shel yad to the shel roish. The Bilari says, I don't have to come to this hekesh. I can learn from the posuk says, v'hoyu lechol le'ois v'lo l'acherim le'ois. Which part of the arm is always covered? The upper part of the arm. Rabbi Yitzchok Oimer, I can learn from the posuk, v'samtem es devorai eila levavchem ukeshartem. Which part of the arm is level to the heart? The upper part of the arm. Rabbi Chiyo hav mechaven umunoch le'gabe libe. Rabbi Chiyo was mechaven, and the twin should be very well positioned, level to the heart. The Shemush Rabbo brings down that only plag zroyo is kosher for tefillin. Only half of the zroyo is kosher for tefillin. What does that mean, only half? The half which is mechuvan keneged the heart. So this that says, b'shem, debei menashe, that the kiboides is the mokom anuchos tefillin shel yad, the biceps, it does not mean the entire biceps. It means the part of the biceps which is level to the heart. And for that you have to divide the arm in half. Upper arm, which is called the humerus bone, the etzem azroya, only half of that arm sees and is level to the heart. And actually, the upper half of the arm sees the heart, not the lower half of the arm. And that's the way Rabbeinu Hananel learns, and that's the mashmos of the Rambam. The marpek is the armpit, the Rambam says in the Pirush HaMishnayos. And that's the hekesh of tefillin shel rosh also. Just like the tefillin shel yad, you can only be mat half of the arm, because only half of the arm sees the heart. The tefillin shel rosh also, not entire shipur is kosher for tefillin, but up to the kotkoit, up to the part of the head which is soft, and that is on the chotzi shipua, half of the shipua, from the hairline up to the kotkoit. The tefillin shel yad teaches the tefillin shel rosh what to put on. The shel yad is only plug zroya, half of the zroya. The shel rosh also half of the shipua. So sikel es yodov, by putting the hands in a cross way, is making a hekesh shel yad to the shel rosh. Tanei beminash al yod chuzuki boires, and means only the chelik which is mechuvan keneged leiv, like Rabbi Yitzchok learns. The shel rosh also at Rosh Ephraim, it means only up to half of the shipua of the kotkoit. Half of Shevet Menashe is going to be in Eretz Yisrael, because Reuven, God, and Chotzi Menashe took the other side of the Yarden. And the Chelek of Menashe is right next to the Yam Kineres. And Yam Kineres is Doime Lelev. The Samtem is Devorai Ela Levavchem. Just like the Tvilin. Only the part of the arm which is level to the heart is kosher for tefillin. Tone de bei menashe, al yot chuzuki boides, which part? Simo keneget alev. Half of the Shevet Menashe, which is next to the Yam Kineres, which is Doime Lelev. Even though in Shulchan Aruch is mashma, that the mark break is the elbow, like Rabbeinu Tam says, nevertheless, Rabbeinu Hanano learns, like Rashi, that the mark break means the armpit. Atzil is the axilia. Atzil is the mark break, the targum of mark break. The Mechab and the Ramo passel the upper half of the arm, because only plug Zroya is kosher, which plug Zroya? The plug which is towards the mark break. And they learn Marpik means the elbow, like Rabbi Nutam. But the Vilna Gaon does not agree with Mechav and Ramo and says the upper half of Tefillin is also kosher. And the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch also is matter the upper half. But since it's a Sofik D'raisa L'choiro, he should be machmir to put on Tefillin only on one half. Which half? We don't know. Only in the lower half and only in the upper half. You could be Yoitze by moving the Tefillin, just like by a Sofik lefty. Somebody's a Sofik, if it's a righty or lefty, he puts on Tefillin in each hand separately. Here also we have a Sofik, which half of the Zroya is kosher for tefillin, the upper half or the lower half, of course in the Mokom HaKiboyres. So the only way to be Yoytze L'Chodadeus is to move the tefillin. No part of the tefillin should be lower than the Kiboyres and no higher than the upper half. And afterwards, no part of the tefillin should be lower than the mediumer's bone. And that's the real, true Neged HaLev. The heart comes down up to the sixth rib. Heart is situated between the second intercostal space till the sixth intercostal space. In other words, between the second rib and the fifth rib. Vayakeo elachoimesh. And he killed them by hitting him on the fifth rib, Rashi says. Because the heart is higher than the fifth rib. The fifth rib is at mid-humerus bone. So by putting tefillin only on the lower half, you're going to be missing the heart. Ikar chosu mina sefer. Ve'atem advekim Hashem elokechem chaim kolchem ayom. Yaakov Avinu was sure that he got married to Rochel. He made up with Lavan. There's no way out. It was a contract. 7 years he worked for Rochel. When came to the Chasana, he switched Rochel for Leo. Yaakov Avinu told Lavan, Ma zoi so si so li. Haloi berochel ovadeti imoch belomorimisoni. Why did you fool me? Afterwards, Yankov goes into business. 20 years he works for his shver. Vatachlef es maskurti aseres moinim. And Lavan was able to fool Yankov 100 times. Akudim, nekudim, brudim, izim, tioshim. Why didn't Yankov Avinu write a contract again? He was burned once. Wouldn't it be smart to learn from your mistakes? In Targum, Yonis ben Uziel says, when Yaakov Avinu met Rochel the first time, Rochel told him, you have to be careful. Lavan, my father, is a big Ramai. Yaakov told him, I know that. My mother told me so. But I am a bigger Ramai than he is. I can fool your father better than he could fool me. It says in Pasuk Chof, Vayignoiv Yaakov es leiv Lavan ho arami. And Yaakov was able to escape from Lavan. Al blihigit lo kiboreahu. Lavan runs after him and he gets him 7 days later. Vayomer Lavan leYaakov, Mo siso, what did you do? Vatignoiv es levovi, and you stole my heart. Lomo nachbeiso livroyach vatignoiv oisi. How did you steal me? How did you fool me? And even Rochel was able to steal the trophim from Lavan. The answer is Yaakov Avinu ish tom. He made himself keilu he's a tom. He doesn't know how to be careful. 100 times he let himself be fooled by his father-in-law. Once he saw that his father-in-law is totally convinced that Yaakov is a tam, that's when he ran away. The one who laughs last laughs louder. ויולן שום בלילו ההוא, וייקח מן הבו ביודו, מנחו לאיסוף אורחיב. What means מן הבו ביודוי? We have several פשוטים. Number one, Rashi says, ביודוי ברשוסוי. And Rabbeinu Bechaya is מסביר, ממה שהשיגו יודוי, ולוי מן הגזל. Kosher objects. Another פשט, Rashi brings down from Medrash, מן הבו ביודוי, אבונים טויבוס ומרגוליוס, precious stones and expensive objects, שאודום צר וצרויר ונויסום ביודוי, that people carry with his hands next to himself. He gave Aesop expensive jewelry. Third פשט, מן הבו ביודוי, חולין. He gave Meiser, like says, Aser Asen Eloch, and from the חולין, he sent the matono to Aesop. Another pshat, Rabbeinu Bechaya brings down, min habo beyudoi, he sent them, oiv hanikro falcon. Aesop was a hunter, and they use falcons to hunt. So he sent, min habo beyudoi, something that Aesop loves to have in his hand, that's a falcon. Something that Aesop appreciates. In the Medrash HaGadol says, min habo beyudoi, those who he was able to catch, the balemumim, but the healthy ones he wasn't able to catch. They were running away from him. And he brings a simen. This is the only place in the Torah that we find 9 endemems, one after another. Mumim. All were ba'ale mumim. Ba'ale meimim. Mumim. And the reason for that is that you should not be makrib with these korbonos to avoid the zorah. But as a kasher, a goy is allowed to be makrib a balmum unless he's a mechuser eiver. And for sure, Yankov would not send his brother, Mechuser Eiver, broken feet, because without he would anger his brother, not appease him. Hakriveyu no lefechosecho hayirtzecho, ho ayosher ponecho? Would you give a present to a sar, a very important person, and the animal is a piseach, a balmum? Of course not. Elomai, you have to say that he sent them treifos that were bifnim. There are two types of treifos, mibachutz and mibifnim. A treifos is an animal that will not last for 12 months. In Darkei Moshe, Simon Yud Aleph Yerdeya brings down that he has a Kabbalah from Rabbi Yehuda Chosid that there is a way to tell whether the animals are treifos or not by patting it. If you pat the behemoth and the behemoth bows down, it's a kosher behemoth. If it does not bow down, it's a treifa. And the simen, leif nishbar benitke elokim lo yisivze. In other words, a kosher behemoth tries to run away from the person, and a treifa lets himself be taken to shechita. Rav Gabriel Zeiv Margolius wants to say, apiremes, this is pshat in the posuk, vayikach min habo beyudoi. He used Rabbi Yehuda Chosid's simen to tell whether it's a kosher or not by patting the behemoth. But whatever was mashpil itself to the earth and did not let himself be taken by Yankov, but the simen that is a healthy animal, and that he left to himself. In the third aliyah, vayi baboiker vehin hileo, in Parshas Vayetz and Shlishi, Yaakov works 7 years to get Rochel, and he makes a contract. I'm getting Rochel bitcho haktano. Don't tell me you have a different Rochel. Don't tell me that Leah's name is Rochel. 7 years later, he gets married to Rochel. Vayi baboiker, and he says in the morning, vehin hileo. Yaakov is mad, tells Lovan, ma zois osisoli, haloi berochel ovadeti imoch, velomo rimisoni. Vayem Lovan, and Lovan says to Yaakov, lo yeyosech. We have a meaning to give first the oldest one and afterwards the youngest one. What kind of words are this? He made a contract. He signed Rochel Bitcho Aktano. He worked 7 years and changed all the documents. Medrash says that Yankov was told by his mother Rivka, you get Lovan's daughter that looks like me, Ifastoyer, Ifasmare, and that is Rochel. And when he met Rochel, Rochel told Yankov Avinu, I have an older sister. My father will never give me before the other one. He is a Ramay. Whatever you're going to tell him, he's going to change. Yankov Avinu told him, I'm a brother in Ramos with him. I know better the job. I bought the Bechoyr for my brother, and with that I was able to steal the Brochos from Yitzchok, and it wasn't against the Haloch because I bought the Bechoyr. I was able to say, Anoichi Esav Bechorecho, I bought the Bechoyr from Esav. So don't worry, I know how to take care of Lovan. And he gave the Simonim to Rochel. What were the Simonim? What it says by the Metzoyro, Oizen Yimonis,
Boin Yodre Monis and Boin Raglay Monis. Rochel was changed Leo, and she gave over the simonim to Leo. In the morning he saw it was Leo. So he asked Rochel, how do you do that? She says, I was not able to let my sister go through Bizoyen. Bizchus dat, Shaul HaMelech, and Mordechai and Esther came from Rochel. As the Gemara says in Masechta Megillah and Masechta Bava Basra. He went over to Lavan and said, how did you fool me? We made a contract. Lavan said, what are you talking about? The meaning over here is the Bechoira goes first. Contract? A contract against a meaning doesn't work. You also did Kunzen with your brother. He told your father that you are Ace of Bechoir because you bought the Bechoira. I am in the same category with you. I did a Pialocha like you. Later, says in the Parsha, Vayar Yankov is Penei Lavan, Vehine Einenu Imo Kismol Shilshoim. And he tells Rochel and Leah, we have to run away. So the Mephoshim explained, Lavan all of a sudden changed his begodim. He put big dates adikim. Yaakov said, now is the time to run away. When he's starting to change his begodim to big dates adikim and act like a tzaddik, even though he's a rosho, that's the time that we have to run away from here. Perek Hey Mishnah Yutes Perkiovos, Ma ben Talmidov shel Avraham Avinu le Talmidov shel Bilam Harosho. So the Mazrich Magid asks, what kind of question is this? How can you compare Avraham Avinu and Bilam? The Teretz is, there's going to be a time that the Bilam is going to disguise himself like Avraham Avinu, and it's impossible to tell the difference between the two. It will be a time that the Shoim are going to look like Tzadikim. The only way to tell the difference is by the Talmidim. Ma ben Talmidov shel Avraham Avinu le Talmidov shel Bilam Harosho. That's what happened with Lavan. He put Big Day Tzadik to start up with Yankov.
Vayeshev Yaakov be'eretz megurei oviv be'eretz kenan. Bikesh Yaakov leishev b'shalva. Kof to olav rugzo shel Yosef. Yaakov Avinu wanted to take it easy, and things got rough. Tzvi Rotberg is masbir. There was a chov of Gezeras Golus. Brisbane Abisorim, 400 years of be'eretz loilohem. It started from Leidas Yitzchok, the second Yitzchok was born. Avraham Avinu had to suffer going from here and there. It was not easy. He went to Eretz Gror. Imagine Avraham with all the COVID in the world, but he cannot stay in Hebron or in Elonei Mamre. He has to go to Gror, to the Plishtim. That's part of Golus. They take away his wells, the water. Yankov wanted to sit Beshalva. He wanted to be Mevatel Gezeras Golus. Yeshiv Yankov be'Eretz Megurei Oviv, in Eretz Israel, where his father went like a ger from here to there. So he had to go down to Mitzrayim. And in Mitzrayim, Yaakov Avinu was able to sit bechvoido shel oil with the biggest covet, not in Eretz Israel, be'eretz lo lohem.
Vayomer Yishov Ali, Vayishov Alo. Yaakov asked Yosef to be koyver him in Eretz Israel, and he asks him to swear on it, and Yosef swore on it. Perek Zayin, Posuk Lamed Aleph. What do you gain by swearing? There's a mitzvah of Kivut Av. If somebody is nishba ala mitzvah, lekayim is a mitzvah, even if he was not mekayim the mitzvah, he does not get an oynish. Like the Gemara says in Masechta Shavuos, Daf Chof Zayin Amud Aleph, hanishba lekayim es a mitzvah, velo kiyem potur, and the Shulchan Aruch Yerdeya, Simen Reish Lamed Vov, Seif Beis, brings it la'alocha. So what does Yaakov Avinu gain by forcing Yosef to make a shvua to take him to Eretz Yisrael lachar moiso? Is a nishba lekayim is a mitzvah, potter is not mechuyiv to be mekayim that shvua. It's mushba ve'omet. This is the kashe from the Penei Menachem, the Gerer Rebbe Zichrono Livracha. Do we gain anything by making a shavua lekayim es a mitzvah or not? And he answers, according to the Shitas Haran in the Dorim Daf Chesomet Aleph, the hanishba lekayim es a mitzvah poter mikorban, aval etzim ha-shavua cholo, ve'im over oleo, loke mishum bal yachel devuro. According to the Ran, gain a lot, because if a person makes a shavua to be mekayim a mitzvah, to eat matzah, and he does not eat matzah, according to the Ran, he gets malchus. Usually, a person makes a shvua to eat something, and he doesn't eat. He gets a korban and malchus. Over here, he only gets malchus according to the Ran. But the Shulchan Aruch does not follow the Ran, and it seems he is potter even for malchus. So, according to the Shulchan Aruch, what does Yaakov Avinu gain by making Yosef a shvua lekayim es a mitzvah? In Sefer, Chelach L'Raise wants to answer, after Yaakov Avinu is nifter, there is no more mitzvah min haTorah to be mechabed and lekayim divrei ameis, only a mitzvah min derabonon. Mechabdu b'chayuv, mechabdu l'achar moiso, nires deshzu, enu midoraise rak min derabonon. Bemelo, Yosef is not mechuyiv to listen to his father midin kivudav, but is mechuyiv to listen listen to the Shvuah, and after Misa is not considered anymore Lekayim es HaMitzvah. After he wrote this, he asked Rav Chaim Kanievsky, Shlita, and he says, according to the Gemara in Sanhedrin, the Pehei Med Beis, it's mashma that the Mitzvah Kibbut Av is Shaykh even Leachar Misa Min HaTorah. The Gemara says, Amekalel is Oviv Leachar Misa, is Chayef. Says in the posuk, Asher Yikal es Oviv es Imo, and the posuk says, Es Oviv ve Imo Kilel. What's the repetition? One posuk is talking about Bechayov, and the other posuk is talking Leachar Amiso. And the Rambam paskens, Amekalel Bechayeyem o Leachar Misoson, Harei Ze Niskal. And that's a psak in Shulchan Aruch Yodea, Simen Resh Mem Aleph, Sif Aleph. So Rav Chaim Kanievsky wants to bring a right from here that min ha-toiro, there's a mitzvah kibbut av even le'achar ha-miso. Because it would be only with the rabbonim, how can be a oynesh miso? But the chelik le'raisa says there is no raya whatsoever from mekalel. There's a chelik between a mekalel and kibbut av. There's a iser mekalel, mebadish, vizoyon, but there is no mitzvah kibbut av. And he says that he found in the sefer Ilui Neshomo, the Agon Rav Tzvi Yavrov Shlita, that there's a big machloikis achroinim, whether there's a mitzvah kibbut av le'achar ha-miso. The Tiferes Yisrael holds there is no mitzvah kibbut av le'achar ha-miso, and the raya is from here. Since the Torah is marbe le'achar ha-miso by mekalel, is only by mekalel that the Torah is marbe, but not by kibbut. The Chidush Arim also says there's no mitzvah kibbut av le'achar ha-miso min ha-toiro, and the Noit Yehuda also says the same. And he brings a raya from the Aruch Shulchan Aruch, Reish Mem Yudalet. If his parents are divorced and both asks him to bring makos mayim, there is no kedima to the father over the mother. The Eizim Masheyirze Yishma. The Navido says, Zedavke Bemegureshes. How about if she is an almono? She lost her husband. His father died. And before he died, he gave a tzivui le'achar moiso. And his mother says, not to be mekayim the tzivui of the father. She is alive, and he is not alive. Even though we say mechabdu bechayov u mechabdu memozo, mikol mokoim, the iker kibbut is bechayim. And the Beis Yosef says, the mother died, and the father says to his son not to say Kaddish because he is alive. And the father is makbid that the son should not say Kaddish because man is alive, even though his mother is not alive. Kibbut av, adiv, mikibbut aim, yerdea simen shin aim vov. But some say that there's a chilik. Over there, there's a bizoyan to say Kaddish when the father is alive. Maybe that's the reason why the father could stop him from saying Kaddish. Because he feels mevuyosh. His son is saying Kaddish and one of the parents is around. But in Sefer Minchas Noson brings a lot of shittas and svoras to say, like Rav Chaim Kanievsky said, that even le'achar miso there's a chiyuv min ha-toiro. So we have a machloikis. Rav Chaim Kanievsky holds le'achar miso is a chiyuv min ha-toiro, and the Chidush Arim and the Noed Yehudo and the Tiferes Yisrael hold there's no chiyuv min ha-toiro le'achar miso. So if there's no chiyuv min ha-toiro le'achar miso, there's a chiyuv shvuah. But according to Rav Chaim Kanievsky, that there's a chiyuv min ha-toiro to be mekayim kibbut av even le'achar miso, comes out this is called nishba le'kayim es ha-mitzvah. What are you getting with that? The answer is, says in Torah Shashua from the Gerei Rebbe, that Mushba Be'omed Har Sinai is not Shaykh Lifnei Matan Toiro. We talk about before Matan Toiro. Maybe before Matan Toiro, there isn't such a thing as Shvuo Lekayim Es HaMitzvah. Because the whole din of Shvuo Lekayim Es HaMitzvah is not Chal, because Ein Shvuo Chalo Al Shvuo. But if he is before Matan Toiro, there's no Shvuo to be Mekayim the Mitzvahs. Agav, what is the halacha if the father asks his son to give him a haircut? Can a son give his father a haircut? In Daz Ekenim Valatoisvis and Parshas Kedoshim brings an iser for a son to give a haircut to his father. And he brings down that Trumas Adeshin was makpit that his son should not be megaleach his zokin, his beard. Shema yaseh bo chaburo. And even Mechila doesn't help, he says. But in Tzlach, from the Noel Be'yehuda says, the Olam lo shamanu v'lo ro'inu she'osur leben legaleach his oviv, and he brings a raya from the Gemara Bovekama against the Daz Ekenim Baletoisves. And the Rambam says, even to take a koitz that's going to bleed, if there's nobody else around, you are allowed to ask the son to take it out. That's the Loch and the Ramor, Resh Mem Aleph, Siv Gimel. So if the father asks his son to give him a haircut, there's nobody around, there's a heter to give a haircut. And the Minchas Yitzchok says Meferesh, it doesn't mean that there's nobody else around in the world. It means nobody else now. Befrat Bizmaneinu, that there's no such a thing as disporis with a messer, with a knife. That's the Psak from Rav Chaim Pinchas Scheinberg Shlita. And Rav Yitzchok Yosef.
הגמרא בשבועות אומרת שאין שבועה חלה על קיום המדווס, כמו שאין שבועה חלה על שבועה. ומי שנשבע לאכול מצה ולא אכל, פטור מהשבועה. ולכן, מי שנשבע לקיים מצוות כיבוד הורים ולא קיים, פטור מהשבועה. אצלנו בפרשה ראינו שיעקב ביקש ליוסף שישבע, שיגבו אותו בארץ ישראל. שואל הגר הרבה בספרו פני מנחם, איך אם כן יעקב ביקש מיוסף, יעקב השביע את יוסף לגבור אותו בארץ ישראל? מה יצא לו מזה? הרי אין שבועי חלה על קיום המצווס, וכיוון שיוסף היה חייב בכיבוד הורים, אז אם כן אין השבועי חלה. הפני מנחם מביא תירוץ על פי הרן, על פי שיטת הרן בנדרים, שנשבע לקיים את המצווה פטור רק מקורבן, אבל עצם השבוע חלה, ואם הוא עבר, הוא לוקה, משום בל יחל לדברו. ואם כן, אחד שנשבע לקיים את המצווה, הוא חייב מלכות, ולכן זה מה שהרוויח יעקב לחייב את יוסף להישבע. זה תירוץ טוב לפי מה שפוסק הרן. אבל לפי השולחן ערוך שלא פוסק, כן, איך נסביר את הפסוק? מדוע יעקב ביקש מיוסף להישבע? מה הרוויח מהשבועה הזאת? החלך לאורייסם תרץ שבאמת מצוות כיבוד הורים זה אך ורק בחיים, כל זמן שההורים חיים, אבל כשההורים מתים אין כיבוד הורים. זה מן התורה. מדרבנן לחינמי יש מן חיוב, ולכן יעקב השביע את יוסף שיקיים את מצוותו לאחר מיתה. אגם שאינו חייב בכיבוד הורים התחייב מדין שבועה לקיים את ציוויו. רב חיים קניבסקי חולק ואומר שהרי יש ראיה מהגמרא במסכת סנהדרין שיש כיבוד הורים לאחר מיתה, שלומדים מפסוק שאפילו לאחר מיתה אם קילל את אביו ואת אמו לאחר מיתה חייב סקילה. אנו רואים שיש כיבוד הורים לאחר מיתה מן התורה, שהרי יש חיוב מיתה סקילה. כך אומר רב חיים קניבסקי, אבל נראה שיש לחלק, כמו ששמעתי מפי אחי רבי שלמה קארו, ולבסוף אמרו לי שזה התפארת ישראל, יש חילוק בין לקלל אבי ואמו ולכבד את אבי ואמו. ובאמת, שינה חינמי, לגבי לקלל התחייב מיתה מדאורייתא, אבל כיבוד הורים מדאורייתא לא יהיה חייב, אלא מדרבנן. וכן פסק הנודע ביהודה והחידוש הערים. יועצה, זה מחלוקת אחרונים האם יש כיבוד הורים לאחר מיתה. אך צריך להבין, לפי רב חיים קניבסקי שאומר שכן יש חיוב מצוות כיבוד הורים מדאורייתא גם לאחר מיתה, אז אנו צריכים להבין מדוע יעקב ביקש מיוסף להישבע, והרי אין שבועה חלה על המצוות. ועל זה תירץ לי רבי רב אריה שכטר, דאין שבועי חלה על המצוות זה מדין דאין שבועי חלה על שבועי, דאוים דיום ונשבועים במעמד הר סיני, דשבוע ראשון אז במעמד הר סיני, ואין נשבועים על המצווס, אי אפשר להישבע על השבועה שנשבענו במעמד הר סיני. ומילא זה, קודם, זה אחר מתן תורה. אבל יעקב אבינו שביקש מיוסף זה היה קודם מתן תורה, אז אין עוד פה שבועה. ממילא חלה שבועה על המצווס, דאין שבועה על שבועה, שהרי לא הייתה פה שבועה ראשונה. זה הקחית לנו הפסוק דן פרשת ויחי, ויאמר ישבעה לי וישבע לו. Yaakov a demandé à Yosef qu'il enterre en Israël. Et sur cette mitzvah-là, de Kibbud Orim, il a demandé, il a fait jurer sur cette mitzvah qu'il enterre en Israël. Dit le gars à Rebbe, ça c'est le din de Shuvua l'Ekayem ta mitzvah. La Gemara dit, Anishba l'Ekayem ta mitzvah, velo kiyem patour. C'est-à-dire que si quelqu'un a juré sur une mitzvah qu'il va la faire, et il n'a pas fait en fait, il est patour. D'après ça, demande le gars à Rebbe, le Pnei Menachem, qu'est-ce qu'il a gagné Yaakov de ce qu'il a fait jurer Yosef? D'après ce qu'on a dit, que si quelqu'un y jure sur une mitzvah, il est patour. Alors il a rien gagné de ce qu'il a fait jurer Yosef sur cette mitzvah de Kibbud Orim. Répond le Gemara Rebbe que d'après le Ran, on pourra bien expliquer. On voit dans le Ran qu'il explique que un nishba lekayem est un mitzvah patour, rak mikorban, aval etzem hashvua chala, vim avar alea loke mishum bal yachel. Que si quelqu'un a juré de faire cette mitzvah, il est patour du korban, mais il doit être hayav malkout parce qu'il est il a passé sur une avera dans la Torah bal yachel et devaro. Ça on pourra bien expliquer d'après le Ran. Mais le Shulchan Aruch, il est pas sévère comme ça. D'après le Shulchan Aruch, même malkout, il est pas hayav. Alors pour expliquer le Shulchan Aruch, qu'est-ce qu'il a gagné Yaakov de ce qu'il a fait jurer Yosef? Le Chelach Leroyta explique qu'il y a pas une mitzvah.
We find in this sedre 8 mem stumos one after another. עזים מוסיים, תיושים עשרים, יחדים מוסיים, אלים עשרים. The Balaturim brings down, and it gave him בעלי מומים, that's the mem, is the rumus of the word mum. All of them were treifus, not kosher animals, something that Yaakov Avinu was not able to use. But it is very difficult to understand. There is an isur genevath da'as. You can be gonev da'as chavero. It's a gemara in chulin. Tzadik Dalet Amit Aleph, Shulchan Aruch Hashemishpot, Resh Chof Chesivot. So what was the heter of Yaakov? Ish Emeth, to be gonev das chaviro. The Tosfos says is al iser de oraisa, and this is what Lavan told Yaakov. The Gemara says, "Vatignov es levovi, you stole my das. Vayignov avsholen es lev anshe Yisrael." The Mechilta says there are 7 types of genevim. The first one is genevas das habriyos. The answer to this question could be the shitas harosh, that there is no iser genevas das by a goy, only by Yisrael. Esa was a mumar. But there is a shitas haritzvo, there is a iser genevas das even by a goy. Even the rice, the answer could be, the only iser genevas das is when the person thinks he gave him a toivo, and he'll never find out that actually he never gave him a toivo. He fooled him. But over here, Esav is going to find out exactly what Yaakov gave him. That's not considered genevas das. He's going to see what he gave him. It's not considered genevas das. That's not a good answer, because Yaakov is going to anger his brother once he sees that he gave him Baalei Mumim. For this, we have to answer something else. There's a Kabbalah from the Sefer Achsidim in the hands of the Shochtim. If you want to tell whether the behemoth is kosher or not, you pass the hand in the back of the behemoth. You tap him. You tap the behemoth. If the behemoth is not kosher, it will not bend down. If the behemoth is kosher, bends down. Every kosher behemoth has to bend down when you pat the behemoth in the back. As merumas in the posik, vayikach Yaakov min habo beyodo. Now this simen, Yaakov Avinu, we have to say, was mekabel b'shem ve'eber, like we have the Kabbalah from the Sefer Chassidim. This Esav did not know. And the reason why Yaakov Avinu did not want to give him behemoth shlemus, he should not be makrif korbonos to the avodo zoro. Therefore, he sent only ba'alei mumin. But the Itur Bikurim asked Akash on this Baal Haturim. Aben Noach, there is no psul korban, only a mechusar evor. For Aben Noach, a treifa is kosher. If Aben Noach brings a korban from a treifa, it's a kosher korban. So what does the Baal Haturim say over here? He didn't want to give him behemoth ksheros, so this way he should not bring korbanos with this behemoth to the avodah zarah. A goy is not makpid in a treifa, only a mechusar evor. The Rinas Yitzchok wants to say that there's a nafkimino between a bomo and a korban l'avodah zarah. For a bomo to be makif to Hashem, a goy is not makpit on a balmum she'enu nikar. Even if it's a treifa, it's kosher for bringing in the mizbeach for Hashem, in the bomo to Hashem. Masheenken for the avodah zarah, the goy's makpit should be the best behemoth with no treifas in the venik inside.
ויקח מאבני המקום, ויוסם מרשויסוף, וישקה במקום ההוא. ויקח איזו אבן אשר סום מרשויסוף, ויוסם אוסו מצבו, וייצוק שמן על ראשו. He starts with avonim, and he ends with אבן. The Gemara in Chulin, Daf Tzadik Aleph and Beis, has this kasha. The Gemara answers, he made a marzev protection against the highest roos, and the avonim started to fight between each other. Olai, yoniach tzadik ez roisho. Every stone wanted that the tzaddik should put his head on that stone. So they came to Amachloikis, and the Ribbono Shel Olam made up Shor. All the Avonim became one. So at the end of the Pasuk says that he took one Evan. They fused, became one Evan. The Mogen Avraham in Simen Mem Beis, if Cotton Gimel, by the two Satfilin Shel Yad. Next to the Beis we make a Kesher Yud. And the other edge, we tie the Tfilin on the hand. Kafa Yad. Somebody wants to switch the size of the Tfilin, and he wants to put the Kesher on the other side, and the Kesher that was next to the Bais, he wants to put it next to the Kafayat. Mogen Avraham does not like that, because Ein Moridin Bakoidesh, the Kedusha's Yud, was next to the Bais, now it's not next to the Bais. The Yud has more Kedusha. But the Lior Rabo argues with the Mogen Avraham, and he brings down from his Zayde, from his grandfather, that there is such a thing as Moridin Mekedusha in one thing. This is one Ritzu. By switching the sides, he's not being Moridin Mekedusha, and he brings a Rai from this Gemara. Once the Avonim were fused, they did not fight anymore. Even though Yaakov Avinu did not put his head on the entire Evan. Same thing with the Ritzu. It's one Ritzu. There's no hoirod bekedusha by switching the sides. The Machaber says, at the end of the Ritzua, you should be koisher. At the beginning of Simon Chof Zayin, that kshira is a chelik from the Ritzua. You should not leave the Ritzua just hanging without a kshira. At least you should be toikev, you should. In the kafayad, you should wind it at least twice. Two tkifas is like a kshira, like a tfiro. Kolo oimer lipol kenofudomi. Agav, how does it work that he puts his head on those stones and he'll be protected from the highest rose? Apiteva doesn't work, but we can say perhaps that was the Mizbeach that Noach was makrif all the korbonos, like the Rambam says. Same Mizbeach of Odom Arishon, Noach, and the Mizbeach of the Akeda. Because the Rilaz also brings it down, the Avonim from the Mizbeach from Avraham Avinu. And that's the Mizbeach that Shlomo HaMelech rebuilt. In that Mizbeach, every single behemoth was nikrav. So by pulling his head on that even, he was protected from any chayro.
Parshas Vayetze in the third Aliyah, Zilpa gives birth to God. Vatoymer Leo, and Leah says, Bo God, Vatikro Shemoi God. God means Mazel. Bo God, Mazel came. God could mean also from Loshon of Karing. God, he was born Mohul, he didn't have to have a Bris Milah. Rashi brings down. Over here we have a Kri and a Ksiv. It's written Bo God, and it's read Bo God. Rashi says he does not know. Why is it written in one word? Velo yudati al mo nichtav tevo achas. I do not know why is it written in one word. In Sefer Em LaMikro from Rav Shmuel Aaron Rubin, he dashes throughout whole Tanakh a Kri and a Ksiv. Why is it written one way and it's read different way? And this posuk Bo God, he brings down Rashi. And it brings down an answer very difficult to understand. B'shem Nezer HaKoydesh and the Medrash. He doesn't really explain. And he ends off V'hadiborim Atikin Atkan L'shoinoy. Things that Rashi would definitely not write in his spiritual Torah. But I found a Chassam Sofer that he says very simple. Since God was born Mohul, that means that he needs Atofas Dambris. And the Hatofas Dambris has to be done V'yom HaShmini. If the Yom HaShmini is on Shabbos, you cannot make a Tovas Dambris on Shabbos because the posuk says Ubayom Hashmini Yimol Besar Losoy Beloy a Tovas Dambrisoy. Like the Gemara says in Mesechta Shabbos Perek Rav Eliezer Miller. So the aloha is you have to make a Tovas Dambris on the ninth day on Sunday. God is Begematria 7 because he was born on Shabbos. God means cut. He was born Mohul. Bo God, in one word, is 9 because the Atovas Dambris was on the 9th day, Chassam Sofer. Somebody says that if you don't know Pshat, you say Alpi Remes. If you don't know Alpi Remes, you say Alpi Soit. But if you know Alocho, you could say Alpi Pshat also. They say on Rav Shaya Kalstirer that before Tkir Sofer, they found them cutting the cake for the oilum. They asked him, how come he's cutting the cake? So he says, big Rebbes, before Tkir Sofer, they're having the Rosin, secrets. But Shaila is mechaven le soiva veloy le ruzoin, should be shefa for Yidin.